Today I am talking about what to wear when out hiking in winter. Now, I absolutely love hiking in winter. However, it's not so much fun when you are freezing cold. So it's so important to get the right layering system for that optimal comfort when out on trail. First of all, let's talk about the two different types of materials. You have got the man-made products, such as your polyester, your nylons, your acrylics, or you've got your natural products, such as your merino wool, your down, your leather, and your cotton. Now, some people have a personal preference. They don't like to choose those natural products, or they might just be allergic to it. Personally, I use the man-made ones, such as your polyesters and your acrylics, that type of thing. But this video will serve as a guide for whatever your preference is. But one thing I will ask you, please leave at home, and that's your cotton items. It is one of those words in the hiking community that nobody likes to hear. Cotton holds on to water, so when it gets wet, it does not dry out. And that can leave you feeling extremely damp and cold and very miserable, and it can ruin a hike. So keep them jeans at home, those cotton tops and those cotton socks, and just wear the other materials because they will provide a lot more comfort and they also help prevent wick moisture away from your body. Now, let's talk about the layering system. It is a three-part system, and the benefit of it is that you can kind of put things on and take things off to keep you most comfortable, so to keep you warm and comfortable. And the main goal is so you don't get too hot and sweaty and overheated. Now, it might be a bit of an uncomfortable thing to have to keep stopping and taking things on and off, but trust me, it's worth it, so you can enjoy your hike to the full. Now, there are a lot of different ways in which you can layer, but this is the way that makes me feel most comfortable. Now, the first layer is the base layer, and the purpose of this is to trap a thin layer of heat against your body, wick away moisture, and also to provide a bit of breathability. Now, the one I am currently wearing is a Rab Pulse hoodie, and it's a tight fitting one, which is what they're supposed to be to keep that heat in. I like the fact that it has got a hood, because then when it's very breezy or cold, you've got that extra layer around your head. And also it has got thumb loops. And I love the fact that these have got thumb loops, because when you've put in gloves on and you've got a top that just goes to your wrist, I sometimes find that that can be quite tricky to get on and off without it bunching up. So the fact that they've got thumb loops keeps it in place as I'm putting my gloves on. I also have another top that I used to kind of switch out with this one, and that is a Mizuno top. I think it's called Mizuno. And again, this is a thin layer, very similar to this with the thumb loops, hasn't got the hood, and it has got a zip. But I prefer the one without the zip, because what I find is if you're wearing a zip on your base layer, zip on your mid layer, and then a zip on your outer layer, you kind of get too much zip on zip, and I find it quite irritating. But they're the two that I use. Secondly, we have the mid layer. Now, the purpose of this is to insulate from the cold. I have broken this down even further because I am somebody that sets off very cold when hiking in winter. So I break it down into two different parts. The first one is a mid-weight fleece, long sleeved. The one I'm currently wearing is a Patagonia one, and I always wear a fleece that is a quarter opening. I don't like those ones that go all the way up to your chin and don't give you that option to be able to open it up and get a little bit cooler if needs be. So a mid-weight fleece, and then what I will then do is pair it with a puffy. And this one is a mountain hardware one with a hood, and it is super warm. I absolutely love this puffy. Now, what I'll normally use this one for is setting off on my hike until I warm up, and then when I stop at breaks, I make sure to put this on whether I'm cold or not, because you can get cold pretty quickly when you stop. And what I like about it as well is the fact that these types of puffies, they compact very small, so you can keep them in your bag as you're hiking. The final layer is the outer layer, or if you prefer, shell layer. Now, the purpose of this is to protect you from the wind, the rain, and the snow. So it's there to keep you dry, because getting wet out on a hike in the cold can lead to hypothermia. This one is again a Patagonia brand, and one thing I absolutely love about this waterproof jacket is the fact that it has got zips in the underarms, which is quite important when hiking. You can get quite hot, even though these waterproof things say that they're breathable, they do get a little bit too stuffy sometimes, so I like having those. Obviously, it's got a hood, and it's also got a cord attachment, so you can kind of cinch it around your face when it's very windy and very wet, so I like that about this. Staying with what I like to wear in winter on my top half, I also wear either a neck gaiter or a buff, as you might call them. I have two different ones that I usually take out with me in winter. I've got this thermal one, which has got like a fleece lining on the inside, which is so warm. And I generally wear that one around my neck. I also have a UV one that I take out with me. Now, if you've not seen one of these before, they're like a long tubular piece of material, like so. And you can kind of mold it and shape it however you want. I like to use these usually around my ears as like a bit of a headband or ear warmer, because sometimes if a hat's a little bit too hot and you want your head to be able to breathe a bit more but your ears are cold, these are perfect. So you kind of roll them up and shape them however you want them. The other thing I obviously then wear is my beanie. So a hat's really important when you're out hiking because you can lose a lot of heat out the top of your head, and it also keeps your ears nice and warm. Now let's talk about gloves. Now I'm going to come across a little bit like a glove hoarder here, but I promise I'm not. It's for a good reason. And that reason is I hate having cold, wet hands when hiking, and especially because I use trekking poles. I think when you're using trekking poles, your arms are up, so the blood doesn't circulate as well, which means your hands get even colder. And if it's raining and you're using trekking poles, you just exposed to the elements. So it's so important to keep your hands warm and dry as much as possible. Now, if it's not terrible rain, what I will tend to do is wear these gloves, which are fingered gloves. It's like a light to mid-weight type of fleecy material by a brand called Rab. Underneath these, if it's very cold, which are mittens. Now this is buffalo mittens, and they are fleece lined, and they're absolutely gorgeously warm. They are so toasty. And I like these because you're not wearing two lots of fingered gloves on top of each other, because I find that really restricting between your fingers. So one pair with fingers and then a mitten over the top, to me, is just like the perfect system for keeping my hands warm. These aren't waterproof though, so if it's raining or snowing, or I know that it's going to be terrible weather, I will take out these gloves instead, which are the Cirrus brand, and that's fully waterproof, weatherproof gloves, and they're much thicker. So I'll wear these probably on their own. At a push, I could wear these under it, but I tend to wear these on their own. One other little tip I will give you as well is just take out a spare set of gloves to keep in your pack when you're hiking. So if you have got them completely soaked and the rain does ease up, at least you've got something dry to keep on your hands to keep them warm. And don't forget your sunglasses. Just because it's winter, it doesn't mean the sun's not out. So make sure you protect your eyes from the sun as well. Also, if you're hiking on snow, it can be quite painful on your eyes. Trust me, I have experienced this. So polarized sunglasses are also a great idea because it does help with a lot of that harsh reflection. But it's not just for the sun that sunglasses are useful for. That cold, biting wind that you get in winter that makes your eyes stream with water, these also help prevent it. You can even get a pair that's not got much tint to it if you prefer, just to keep it out of your eyes. I am a big fan of soft shell trousers, and I've just recently got two new pairs for this winter because I was lacking a little bit with warm trousers for winter. The one I am currently wearing is the Mountain Equipment ones. Now these are a gorgeous pair of trousers for cooler weather. They're designed for mountaineering and trekking, and they fit so nice. They've kind of slim fitting, but they keep me really warm. They've got a nice soft lining on the inside, plenty of pockets. They've got the zip at the bottom, which goes all the way up to mid-calf. So I can actually get my Wellingtons on underneath these if I want, but they're also perfect for hiking boots. They're shower resistant and super warm. And what I like the best about these ones is that they're very stretchy and not too bulky. So great pair of trousers, love these. The other pair that I wear to go hiking are these ones. Again, they're a soft shell hiking trousers by a brand called Regatta. And these are a lot bulkier and a lot thicker, but also a lot warmer. And these are very similar in the sense that they've got the zip at the bottom, the pockets, and a really nice fleecy lining. One other thing that I do like wearing sometimes in winter, and this is when it's definitely not going to snow or rain or be too windy, and that's a pair of leggings. Now I've got this pair here, it's so old that I've had them quite a long time, but they are so comfortable and warm. I think they're called Rab Power Stretch Leggings, so if anyone wants to look them up, I'll highly recommend these. They're classed as a base layer, but I tend to just hike in them. They've got a lovely fleece lining, so yes, highly recommend those. And then lastly, what you definitely have to have when hiking in winter is a pair of waterproof trousers. Now, the ones I've got are Burhaus ones, and I like these because they have got zips that go, let me show you, all the way up here, so very high up on you, all the way down to there. And it's also got kind of press studs along the side so that if you do get hot, you can unzip it and keep the press studs closed. And you've got that breathability going through you when you hike in the rain and the showers. And also these act as a perfect layer. So if you are out and the wind is extremely cold and you need a bit of protection from it, these will kind of protect you as a windproof layer as well. For your feet, again, try and avoid cotton socks where possible. Make sure that they fit well. I like to wear a thinner pair of sock when I'm out hiking. I wear a brand called Bridgedale at the moment. These are perfect for me. And the reason why I wouldn't recommend those thick, bulky socks to hike in is that although they may come across as more insulating, when you're hiking and you've got shoes constricting around your feet, what it actually does, it reduces the circulation of blood in your feet and it can actually cause your feet to be a lot colder. So just be a bit mindful of that. If, however, you have got bigger shoes or bigger boots to accommodate the thicker socks, that's probably fine, but just something to bear in mind when you're purchasing socks and shoes together, make sure that it all fits well. Now, one thing I would highly recommend you do is carry a spare pair of socks in your pack. So if you need them, you've got them, because there's nothing worse than wet feet. And also, they will also double up as a pair of spare gloves if needed. I have done that once before. If you struggle a lot with cold feet, something else I can recommend is a pair of neoprene socks, such as these. Now, these by a company called NRS, and they are not waterproof, but they provide an extremely insulating layer. And what I do is wear these in my shoes, especially if I know I'm going to be standing around a lot, because I can get quite cold feet. I wish I had these when I was out doing some photography a few years ago when I was trying to catch mountain hares. Trust me, I will be wearing them a lot this winter. They're not waterproof, but they do keep your feet nice and warm. And plus, if your feet do get wet, for some reason that water that's wet will stay warm as well. So highly recommend neoprene socks if you get extremely cold feet. Another thing to think about with your feet and your hands as well is hand warmers or toe warmers. So you can get things like that, take out with you, and then if you do get uncomfortably cold, you can break those out and use them as well. For my feet, I like to wear trail runners most of the time, and I think that goes against the norm a little bit. I am a bit of a fan of trail runners. However, if I'm hiking out in the snow or if it's planning on being a very bad rainy day, then I will wear my boots. Another reason I'll wear my boots is probably if I'm going on a trail when I know it's going to be quite icy and I need that extra support for my ankle. But otherwise, I will tend to wear trail runners. So you choose what you prefer to wear on your feet. Something else to consider as well is if you're hiking through deep snow, you might look at getting something like snowshoes to help you hike across that easily, rather than having to go through the snow up to your knees all the time, which can be very tiring and time consuming. Another option for you is something like micro spikes like these. This is ones I've got by Kalula, the brand is, and all you do is you attach them over your boot or your trail runner, and it gives you that grip if the trail's a little bit icy or if you've got some shallow snow. Gaiters are also something you might want to consider wearing between your boot and your knee. They're there to prevent snow and water getting in through the top of your shoes, so they're perfect for hiking through snow. Just make sure that they're waterproof and breathable. Now, be careful of your skin. Any skin exposed to freezing temperatures and cold winds is prone to frostbite, so just be extra careful of things like your nose, your cheeks, your ears, and your fingers, and also your toes. Now, on that, don't wear any tight clothing in winter, because you need your circulation to be working as best as possible. So make sure your boots are not tied up too tightly around the ankles. If you've got a wristwatch, make sure that's not too tight, and also ensure that the cuffs of your gloves and socks even fit perfectly, because any reduced blood supply can bring on frostbite. Another thing you might want to consider is a head torch. I always carry one of these out with me, not just for safety reasons, but because I do not want the sun stopping my hike early. We might have reduced daylight hours, but just because the sun goes down, it doesn't mean your hike has to end. Always make sure to bring spare batteries though. And a word on batteries and electronics. In the cold weather, batteries and electronics just die quickly. They do not last as long as they're supposed to last. So if you're not used to hiking in the cold, you might find that your phone loses its charge a lot quicker. So wear your electronics. And I know that sounds strange, but this is a what you wear when hiking video. So wear your electronics, put them in the pockets of your coat or close to your skin to keep them warm, because they will last a lot longer. Another thing to remember is sunscreen. You still need to protect your skin from the sun. You've still got those UV rays coming, even though it's cold. And plus, sunscreen can also help with a bit of the windburn as well. So I find that does help me a lot. So that's also something to consider. But one thing to bear in mind, I know I've talked a lot about certain brands today and a lot of items of clothing, but it does not have to be expensive. You do not have to have branded gear. You do not have to have expensive gear to go out hiking in winter. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, please don't hesitate to put them down below. I'll also link as much as I possibly can from what I've talked about today in the description box if you want to check out what I wear. But otherwise, I hope you enjoy your hikes out in winter. I know I'm certainly looking forward to them. And I will see you soon. Goodbye.